Hey folks, it's your buddy Glenn with the almost world famous Cactus Atlas, and today I'm going to be exploring Bisbee, Arizona. The story of Bisbee really begins right here in 1877. In the vicinity of this large rock, today known as Castle Rock. Back in May of 1877, a cavalry unit rode out of Fort Bowie, Arizona, to come to this area to find a renegade band of Apaches that were causing problems in the area. In 1877, this would have just been pure frontier. There wouldn't have been any buildings here, nothing, just wilderness. One of the first orders of business for this cavalry unit was to find a source of water, and they found a natural spring right over in this vicinity where that red building stands today. As the men surveyed a little bit more of the area, they discovered coloration on rocks that indicated potential valuable metals, and they wanted to go ahead and rush to file a claim. Now, I'm not gonna go into all of the detail about what happened after that immediately, but needless to say, this ended up becoming a huge boom town, a very successful town, one of the largest towns between New Orleans and San Francisco at the time. So enter the Inn at Castle Rock. This is a very fascinating building here. It was built in 1895, and today it serves as a hotel, and you can stay in it. But there's something special inside that I want to go show you guys that relates to the cavalry unit we're talking about. So I got some really cool information from the lady working downstairs. The well that's inside the building here was an old mine shaft that three men dug and tunneled through underneath the Castle Rock here in front of us. Apparently they struck water and then the thing flooded very abruptly. Apparently one man died trying to get out. So I hadn't heard that one before, but that's pretty brutal if that's the case. And today it's just a well, once again, inside the building. I mean, that's so cool. Kind of creepy too, but very neat. And while we're here, I suppose I can just give you a quick look at my room so you can kind of get a taste for what this building is like. All of the rooms here at the Castle Rock Inn are themed very differently, and when I booked it online, they only had a couple available online through the service I use, but I chose the one that I wanted anyway. This is the Geronimo room, themed after the famous Apache warrior Geronimo. Now you can see, I mean, definitely not the fanciest room, but it is. The decorations are awesome. I mean, this is really, really cool. Now it is kind of creepy in the middle of the night when you have to get up and use the restroom to have old Geronimo judging you. And this too is pretty creepy. Lots of faces here right above the toilet. This guy's standing guard. And then another, this is a Dakota warrior. I need to learn more about my the history of this aspect of the Old West. But anyway, it's really cool. But anyway, these guys have a tendency to stare at you. Now, my little ghost story, I guess. This place is supposed to be haunted, by the way. And the legend that I heard was there was a miner, I want to say sometime in the 1930s, that was cleaning a firearm, was staying in this lodging, and there was a woman walking across the street, and he accidentally discharged his weapon and shot and fatally killed her. So her ghost is supposed to haunt here, and she's still looking for her assailant, they say. And I don't believe in that stuff, as I told you guys many times before, but I did have a weird experience last night that I think I'm gonna write off as human cause, but let me explain what happened. So it was about, I don't know, maybe I want to say it was like 2:40 in the morning, like just no reason for people to be up and about, but you never know. But I was asleep, and a noise woke me up, and it was the door to the room here, and it was shaking like somebody was trying to get in. And I looked up, and then I heard footsteps walking that way, so I just kind of wrote it off as a patron. Maybe they got back late or something and they were trying to get into the wrong room. I couldn't see any like form of like a shadow of somebody walking out, but It was just odd, a very peculiar hour, and the way they went about it, it didn't sound like they were trying to insert a key into the keyhole. It was just like the door was going. So, anyway, I was so tired that at the time I wrote it off as just someone was lost, but now I'm thinking about it more. That probably is what it is, but just a very odd occurrence to happen at like 2:45 in the morning. So I'll leave it up to you guys to decide.
One other thing I'm gonna give you a little heads up on, for those of you that might care, is they don't have televisions in the room here, which I prefer, but they do have this common area that you're allowed to come out here, I think 24 hours a day and just chill out. Really neat atmosphere. I really like this area. And like a breakfast area, you can eat over here, whatever you want. Oh, this is cool. I didn't even see this. What is this? Wow, this is like the most narrow stairway of all time. It looks like it goes up to an attic. I'm doubtful that I'm supposed to be poking my head in there, so. That's just odd to make something so small. Big guys like me have a hard time getting up that. They have coffee here. And bagels, so maybe I should have some breakfast here actually. Take advantage of this for once. We'll put some links below to this hotel, so in case you're interested in checking it out for yourself, we'll make it easy for you, but highly, highly recommend it. Such a cool ambience in here. All right, so let's get down into the downtown Bisbee area, which is right around the corner with an easy walking distance of the inn at Castle Rock, which is awesome. Just right around the corner, but apparently this used to be part of an old stagecoach route too, this area right here. I've seen some old pictures, it's really cool. I also want to introduce to you the crack cocaine of my life, the stuff called Coca-Cola with coffee. If you've not tried it, it's not for everybody, but I can't stop drinking this stuff. It's so bad, so bad. So Bisbee, like many towns back then, had a devastating fire that probably destroyed a lot of the old wooden Old West buildings, but this whole town is supposed to be absolutely grand. It was supposed to be the hip-hopping place back in the late 1800s into the 1900s. You can see you've got all these really historic structures here. This bank building, which still serves as a bank today, it's the Western Bank, established in 1907, but apparently this was the Bank of Bisbee also in 1902, prior to it becoming the bank, the Western Bank. I assume anyway, I assume that's what that sign means. Perhaps even better than the front-facing facades of the buildings are these alleys back here. You can really like get a look at the awesome architecture up there. Bisbee was built on the mining industry, and there are tons of mines around here. Copper was at the top of the list here, although I think they did find gold, silver along with that, but this is really a copper town. It's known as the queen of the copper camps. And this area is really neat. There's a building behind here that I want to see called the Copper Queen Hotel, named after one of the mines here. It's also supposed to be haunted. I think there's an old church back there also. And then this really cool looking mining museum, which was not open yet, but I'm going to try to sneak in if time permits. Wow, there's some absolutely beautiful gardens back here and flowers. Look at all this. And as you can see, we're starting to see evidence of mining all over the place here. Surprise, surprise. Let's go take a look over here at some of this stuff. That's an old cage that they would lower down into a mine. And I think these were little trolleys that they used, not in the very beginning. Men used to push carts by hand, and then that was followed up by mules. And then they finally had electric trolleys like this that could tow a lot more than man or mule could do. But some cool mine carts here to take a look at. Ooh, explosives. Yeah, this is a cool town. It's really artsy. Everybody here is really cool. It's one of the few places I don't feel like a freak doing YouTubing. I think I fit in just fine here. So check that out. It's the Copper Queen Motel.
I've seen this on television, but never with my own eyes. Let's go take a peek inside the old Copper Queen, see if we see any ghosts, minor ghosts. Love it when the floor creaks underneath your footsteps. It's a sign of a proper old building. I wonder if that's an original one. Amy, I want to get one of these for our house. We can listen to our crazy music on this. That'd be pretty cool. Yeah, that makes me want to check this place out even more. It was actually my first choice when I was shopping around for a hotel on this trip, to be honest, because I was more familiar with this than the inn at Castle Rock. And the service that I booked through the reviews were, seems like they have some work to do to update some things, but I'm not that fancy. I don't require that much, but the place I stayed at, had much higher reviews on the service I use. So that was really my own decision, but I think we're going to do this here, on a future episode for sure. And they do have the town adorned with Christmas lights, and, it's beautiful at night, but I'm here early morning. Just capturing in the sun-kissed hilltops here, mountaintops of the Mule Mountains. And here you get a really good look at just how crazy they build these towns up into the hill, very much like Jerome. Reminds me very, very much of that. The thing that I love the most about these towns is if you go back to the very beginning, the roots of a lot of these mining towns, it all started with a couple prospectors striking a claim, getting excitement going, having people move here. And as they started to build this up, keep in mind, this was a time where you went from very manual things, mule-powered things, really no electricity, but then these towns started to introduce those modern conveniences around the turn of the century. So this is really where, an example of where I think the old Wild West was tamed, so to speak. Like many other towns we visited. Every like 5 steps, I'm distracted by things like this, these really old hand-painted signs. Now, I shouldn't say really old, because I don't know if these are just recreations. This, however, looks like it used to be a Coca-Cola sign. You can still make out the words. It's very faded with time. And then you got another one over here. Not quite sure what that one was, but that was definitely Coca-Cola.
A fake cowboy. And I make the YouTubes, and I hope you like it, because I try so hard.
I had to do it. Without further ado, before we head to our grand finale for today, we're going to explore the Bisbee Historic Mining Museum and check this out, learn a little bit about that, and then you're going to want to stick around for what happens next. How did I not see those giant flies? You know, it'd be really freaky is if those things actually moved and flew away. I think I'd be done with Bisbee if that was the case. So I'm inside the Bisbee Historic Mining Museum. Just a heads up, they are strict about masks. I brought my schmog, maybe that would have worked, but for a buck, they'll sell you one if you need one, but they do require it. So that's why I'm wearing it today. I'm especially interested in like old photos like this one over here. Just to kind of see what the town used to look like before, what it looks like today. You can kind of see this is a built-up time. I love how it's kind of like a 3D effect. They've layered pictures upon pictures here. It's beautiful. Really has a lot of depth. I love that. This is something interesting. The magic window. Sit down, line up your eyes with those of the face inside, and move your face towards the glass. Until your face merges with the one inside. Wiggle your eyebrows and your mouth. So I see what they're going for there. If you look at your reflection of your face, you kind of merge it with this, but it doesn't work so good with a mask on. Wow, and this really shows you how big the industry was here. Bisbee, Arizona. No date though, did I see on that? Actually, I take that back, 1898. And by the way, I was told this is one of the oldest buildings constructed here. That still stands in Bisbee. It used to be like the mining operation headquarters for the mines around here. And I think there's like a executive boardroom that's still here in this building that we'll go find. And here we are, a miner with a drill, drilling holes to stick dynamite
in. Now, I don't know if this is an accurate portrayal, because I don't know if they would do it at an angle like this. I could be wrong, but you can see like gold veins going up in copper up there. I assume that would be gold and copper. I'm not sure. That certainly looks like copper though. This is the stuff that I really like, is seeing the dress of the time, what people looked like here. It's something that would be unrecognizable today, really. I mean, unless you're watching an old movie or something, but you could see gentlemen here. I don't know if that's Pharaoh they're playing, some kind of table card game. Did you enjoy playing Pharaoh, sir?
This is one of those places that just tells you about the life and times of these people. It's really cool to get an insight into that time and to see pictures and stuff like that. That's what I really get out of these museums. But it is one of those places where lots of like old newspaper articles and lots to read. So I unfortunately didn't spend a lot of time. I don't have a lot of time to explore. I'm just kind of blowing through this today, but I'm liking this a lot and there's a lot of reason to come back.
Ah, this is the old executive boardroom. This is lush. Wow. So for those of you into the history of Jerome, this guy, James Douglas, should be familiar to you. He, I think, is very responsible for getting this town booming also. Probably more so than anybody, in my opinion.
I have just run out of time, though, for my itinerary today. I'm trying to cram in a lot, but I just wanted to give you guys a quick look here at this awesome museum. And one of these days, I'm going to come back and read every word printed here, I promise. But until then, let's get back outside. So that mining museum was amazing. We really got to see a glimpse at what people looked like at the time, and especially what mining was like in the early days and how the technology progressed things. But this episode would not be complete without us actually delving in and exploring a real old mine, which we're going to do next. So the next thing I wanted to explore here in Bisbee is the Queen Mine. This is going to be really cool, but we can actually go into the mine very far into a mountain here to get a glimpse at what mining life would have been like.
We're about to put on our hard hats, grab a flashlight, and then head 1,500 feet into an over 100-year-old section of the Queen Mine. This is hard rock mining up close and personal.
That is the entrance to the mine. And you can see we're about to go deep inside.
Copper is what Bisbee is known for, and this is an old copper mine. I've never done anything quite like this one before. This is gonna be something unique. All right, as you can see, I am suited up and ready to get inside this mine. This is gonna be exciting. Let's do it.
And partners, for your safety, remain seated with your hands, arms, feet, and legs inside the train, and be sure to watch your kids. If any of you folks are wearing hats or glasses, just remove them, because this here's the wildest ride in the wilderness.
Well, on second thought, folks, best not remove them for safety's sake and all. That ain't like tight spaces, this might not be the experience for you. But early on, they stopped to check if anyone wants off, and we almost had one taker.
Okay, we're about 150 feet inside the mine here. Now, how'd you look at that date out there? 1915 is when they made this tunnel. We're sitting.
Yep, you heard them right. 1915. That's 106 years ago from when we filmed this, and you're about to go in deep. About as deep as the Central Park Tower is tall.
That's the original shaft right there. Oh my god, see that? There's an ore cart down there. That's awesome.
It just keeps going and going. I admit it made me a mite bit nervous, but we'll get to stretch our legs here in just a bit. What do we got here? Is this Carlsbad Caverns?
OK, Okay, folks, this right here is what you call a stope, S-T-O-P-E, meaning it has been drilled and mined. This was never a cave, never a cavern, or a place. A stope is also a place that's going to be drilled and mined right there. That you can see into this Copper Queen mine right there is the original opening into this place right in here back then and up to this day, still called the Old Glory Hole.
Now, why is that guy laughing? Glory Hole? I don't, what's so funny about Glory Hole?
Well, that was neat. That was a stope. Huge. Biggest I've ever seen.
The deeper we went, the more the mine resembled one of them modern video games or one of them Hollywood movies.
All right, another stop on the tour.
These are old ore chutes here. And they would lower, back in the early days, they would put about 3/4 of a ton of rock in there, and a man would push that out before they started using mules. But this is awesome.
You're gonna stick a dynamite blasting cap, 12-foot of fuse, and you're gonna push it very slowly to the back of the hole. So what you're gonna do with the first one right here is you're gonna get it, and you're gonna cut 16 inches off of that one right there. Any one of your relievers can go next. And you're going to light it every time.
Interesting. I don't recall this from last time. This doesn't seem normal. Lady, could you move a little bit faster? I got a bad mutton shunter.
Right here. This controls your bucket. This, of course, going forward, as you were filling it up, you bring it back, go back, and it would dump into your ore car. And it was air-driven. And the reason after you blast it, you had to bring the rock to the front of this right here was because it ran on rails. It's not anyways a two-seater. I don't know if they ever used a two-seater, but we can take pictures of two people at the same time on it.
So if you guys can go back and do it all over again, would you choose this profession, do you think?
Yeah, because I kind of did a little bit of everything, mm-hmm. you know. Mining was good. I liked the mining, and then like I was telling them right here, that I had 16 years with the company, okay? Mm-hmm. And I had 10 years with the sheriff department, 20 years with the probation department. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And so, you know, that gets a little scary out there too nowadays. So,
yeah, yeah, definitely.
Yeah. Yeah. We're always looking for guys like this right here. You know?
So that was the conclusion of the tour. I didn't realize you get to get out and walk. That was amazing. We're still heading back to the train now, but this is fantastic. Okay, so the Queen Mine Tour, oh my God, that was amazing. And I wanted to say so much during the journey, but obviously it was a guided tour, really loud riding on that contraption that took us in that tram. But wow, that was so amazing. I didn't realize too that you actually get to get off and walk off on foot. And that stope we saw and the other areas of walking through the mine, that was the pinnacle moment for me, was just being on foot, walking in that place where miners from days of old toiled hard, lived hard lives working in there. Man, gotta respect that a lot. Okay, so we blew through Bisbee. Maybe that should be the name of this video, is Blow Through Bisbee, because we really did. Just time was not on my side as usual. I try to cram in a lot. Just wanted to give you a taste. And as I always do, I always come back now that my appetite has been whetted. I will be back.